Hello children, welcome to our English teacher video lessons. Where we are now? Yeah, in the grammar session from the third unit. We have finished two sessions already on the grammar. If you have any doubt, you go through those two videos, watch them carefully and your doubts will be clarified. Then come to this session, watch it and enjoy it children. It will be very clear to you if you go through those two previous videos, then come to this video, children. Okay. Shall we move to our present session, children? Yeah. Before going to this present session, what have we learnt in the previous sessions? Direct indirect speech. Changing given sentences from direct speech into indirect speech, especially when the given verb is in present tense, children. We have learnt both assertive sentences and interrogative sentences, and those interrogative sentences again with question words and helping verbs. Isn't it, children? Let's come to the session, present session now, children. Now, today we have past tense, future tense, conditionals, and unreal past. How to change these sentences into indirect speech when the tense given is in these types? As I have already told you, past tense becomes past perfect, no children? It's very clear to you. You can change whatever the sentence I give you here in past tense, you can change it easily into indirect speech, children. Okay, let's have a look at the one example here, children, for our convenience. She said to her mother, "I wrote my exam well." It's a quite common expression you use in your life situations. Suppose if you just imagine the situation, you finish your exam, reach your home, then automatically you express it out of happiness to your mother. "I wrote my exam well. Mom, I wrote my exam well. I did my exam well." Okay, isn't it? Yeah. So how to change this statement into indirect speech? Let us see. In indirect speech, she said that, she said to her mother that, we can write it, she said that. She, I, who does this word refer to? I, speaker. Who is speaker here? She. So, I becomes she. Wrote, it is in verb 2, no children? So, verb 2 becomes had plus verb 3. Had plus verb 3, no children? So, it's a quite common change that takes place while changing given sentence from direct to indirect when the given verb is in past simple. Okay? She had written her exam well. My exam is here. Whose exam? Speaker's exam. Who is speaker here? She. So, her becomes, my becomes her. She had written her exam well. Is it clear, children? It's very clear. Repetition. Next, let's come to the another example. Had teacher said, "Did you complete your test?" Generally, we ask you to know whether you have finished your exam or not, no children. So, if I told you already, suppose if the helping verb is used as question word, what comes? Yeah, if or whether as condition, no children here. So her teacher asked, it's a question, no? So we use this word asking. Her teacher asked if or whether. In the previous session I told you already, if comes here, if next to inversion of subject and verb take place here. Because we are changing this question into assertive sentences, statement, no children. So, if she did complete means it's a V2 form. Did complete, V2 form. So, here becomes, did complete becomes had completed. V2 becomes, this V2 becomes had plus V3. Her test. Your test. Whose test here? Her teacher said, "Did you complete your test?" Student's test. So, we can write here, her or his. It's your, okay? Because the gender is not given here, no? So, we can, student. Student may be he or she. So, we can write here, her or his test. Is it clear, children? Very simple. Past simple becomes past perfect. And in our previous session, we have dealt already about the interrogative. So, how to change? If question word is there, how to change it? If helping verb is there as a question word, how to change it into statement. Okay, while changing it from direct speech into indirect speech, we have to change the question into statement, children. Now let us see. But here also, while changing the given verb from simple past to past perfect, we have exceptional cases also, children. Let us see what those exceptional cases are. The teacher said, when I was teaching in my previous school, we often conducted literary competitions. Here, what is the adverbial clause is there, no? Time clause is there. What is the time clause here? When I was, subordinate clause. You know, I think you know something about the clauses, children. So here, what is the subordinate clause when I was teaching in my previous school? Just for the sake of your understanding, just I shall touch it and go to the next examples. Because the sentence which we can, this is the complete sentence. In this complete sentence, we have two clauses, and the clause which we cannot, we cannot divide it independently, are the part of the sentence which cannot stand on itself is a subordinate clause, and the part of the sentence which can stand on its own and gives us complete sense is the main clause. So here, when I was teaching in my previous school, it is a subordinate clause, and we often conducted literary competitions is the main clause, and these two together with the conjunction when becomes a complete sentence, and this part of the sentence can be can stand on itself, it gives us complete sense. But this, when I was teaching in my previous school, is incomplete sentence. So it has to depend on its meaning for the on this sentence. Without this sentence, we cannot write this sentence. So it's a subordinate. So this here adverbial of time is there. When let us have a look at this. How to change it into reported speech? The teacher said that when, as it is time adverbial of conjunction. When I becomes he or she. Here the it is not specified whether the girl or the boy. So the teacher said simply, he when I was. So when he, the teacher may be he or she, gender. Here gender is not given. So you can write he or she. The teacher, when I means here speaker, no? Who is the speaker? Teacher. So when he or she, you can write when he was teaching or when she was teaching. Suppose if you write he, you have to write his. If you write she, you have to write her. My becomes again speakers. So my becomes here third person. His or her. Previous school. They. We becomes they. We means here teacher. Yes. With the teacher, there are some more members. It's a situation, imagine situation. So they often conducted. Often conducted becomes here past perfect tense. Had often conducted literary competitions. So here look at the in this complete sentence we have two past tense. One past tense in the subordinate class and another past tense in the main class. So there will be no change in the tense of the subordinate class or time class, but the verb given in the main clause changes. So this is the exceptional case. In subordinate clauses, the main clause or the subordinate clauses or the adverbial clauses, time clauses, there will be no change in the tense. Past simple remains as it is in past simple, but the verb in the main clause changes into past perfect. Their past simple changes into past perfect. Is it clear to you, children? Again, once again, let's come to it once again. Here, in this sentence, we have two clauses. It's a complex sentence. Here, we have two clauses. When he was teaching, when I was teaching in my previous school, we often conducted literary competitions. So I told you already, this was the, what is this clause? Subordinate clause, time adverbial time clause, and then that clause is main clause. So here there is a change. Is there any change in the adverbial time clause? Is there any change? No change. So when, only pronoun changes. Speaker becomes third person. When he or she was teaching. In his or her previous school. Pronoun changes, but there is no change in the tense. So keep it in your mind, children. And next let's come to the main class. They here often conducted becomes had often conducted. Is it clear, children? So here in the main class, past tense changes into past perfect. But in the subordinate class, past simple remains as it is. Is it clear, children? So while changing these complex sentences, you keep it in your mind, children. The clause, the adverb, the time clause in the tense in the adverbial clause or time clause, it does not change while changing it into indirect speech. But the tense in the main clause, it changes into past tense. Suppose if it is in past simple, it changes into past perfect. Is it clear, children? Yes. Next, let's come to the next example. She said to her, she said to her friend, she said to her friend, I decided not to play because the doctor advised me to take rest for 2 days. Here, look at this example. She said to her friend that she had decided not to play because the doctor advised her to take rest for 2 days. Just like this example only. Here, I decided not to play. It's an independent clause. It's a main clause. And here, what is the verb given here? Verb to. Yes, this verb to becomes... Here is a verb 2 and this becomes had plus verb 3. Had plus verb 3. So, in the main class, just as in the earlier example, here also in the main class, verb 2 becomes had plus verb 3. And in the subordinate class, there will be no change. The doctor advised, advise her, me becomes her, to take rest for 2 days. Okay, children? Yeah. Is it clear to you? Likewise, you can write as many examples as possible on your own and try to change them into reported speech. You can take live examples from your classroom situation, children. Generally, you use many types of... you can write using many types of situations that occur daily in your classroom, children. Next, let us take it. Is it clear? Now, we have dealt, yes. What are the different types of examples that we have dealt with so far? From changing direct speech into indirect speech? Yeah. Present tense. 4 forms of present tense. Present simple, present continuous, present perfect continuous. And past simple, past continuous. And there are 2 exceptional cases and complex sentences just now as I have told. Okay, children. Now, let's go to future. Now, suppose if the given statements are in future tense, what changes do occur? Let us see. He said to future tense becomes conditional. For your, here, let us have a look at this example, children. He said to the teacher, I shall submit my proposal tomorrow. It's a quite common situation that takes place in our classrooms, no, children. Generally, we ask you to submit your project first, but you postpone it. Ma'am, tomorrow I shall submit. Ma'am, day after tomorrow I shall submit. After 2 days I shall submit. Likewise, you give your answers, no, children. That same example I have written here. I shall submit my project tomorrow. How to change it into reported speech? Let us see. He said to the teacher that, I miss your whole student. So, he... speaker, no? So, he, then here we use would. Generally, we should, we never write he should. We write generally he would. Shall, we use it with the subject pronoun, first person pronoun, I shall, we shall. But he should, he would, she would. Or he could, she could. We can write that. He would submit his project work the next day. Tomorrow becomes the next day, no, children? So, in this sense, so, shall becomes would. I told you already in the first class, the shall becomes should, will becomes would, can becomes could, may becomes might. The changes take place while changing these conditionals, past conditional. Present conditional becomes past conditional. Okay, here, children, he said to the teacher, I shall submit my project work tomorrow. He would submit his project work the next day. In this way, you can write as many examples as possible, children. Try to write in your notebooks at least 5 examples of your own using this future tense and change them into reported speech. You have number of situations, you face number of situations in your classroom, children. Now let's have a look at the another example. Future continuous becomes conditional continuous. Sometimes, suppose if your friend asks you to, just imagine the situation, if your friend asks you to come to a film, to watch a film, or to come to play with you, then what do you answer? Suppose if it is convenient to you, you accept the, yes, you accept your friend's invitation. Suppose if it's not convenient to you, if you are going to have some other work on that, at that particular time, what do you say? You say like this, I shall be doing the project tomorrow by this time, because the time does not permit you to do that particular activity, because you have your own work. So what type of examples do you give generally at that time? I shall be doing the project tomorrow by this time. So here, now let us see how to change it into reported speech. She said to her friend that, quite common, it's a conjunction. She, I becomes she. Why? Because speaker is she here. So she, as in the earlier example, she shall becomes would be doing the project work the next day by this time. Is it clear, children? Yeah. I shall becomes he would or she would. Okay. Next, conditional becomes conditional only. And unreal past. Okay, before conditional means, what do you mean by conditional? Oh, we should respect elders. Suppose if I say, you should respect elders. So, that, how do you change it into reported speech? The teacher said that we becomes they. They should respect elders. Suppose if I address you along with me, including me, we can use the same pronoun, we. The teacher said that we should respect elders. Okay, children. Next, you should visit the doctor. Just imagine the situation in the classroom. You are suffering from, suppose if I see you suffering from fever, then generally what do we say to you? You should visit the doctor once. So the teacher, yes, ask to visit the doctor once. You can say in this way, or the teacher asking, I should visit the doctor if you want to report yourself, or if the reporting person is third person, the doctor, the teacher said that she should visit the doctor. She should, is it should or would? Yes. There will be no change in the tense, conditionals. So, unreal past. Now let's come to unreal past. While changing this unreal past, there will be no change in the tense, children. You may or may not have any, I don't know whether you have any particular idea about this unreal past. Generally, imaginary situations. Unreal past means is nothing but imaginary situations. And so just imagining the situation, suppose if something might have taken place, what would happen like that? For your understanding, here I have given you one example. He said, it's time we bought a new dictionary. That means still you have no dictionaries with you. So your friend is saying with you, it's time we bought new dictionaries, because you miss it a lot because of not having your dictionaries on yourself. So it's the time we bought a new dictionary. Then how to report it into indirect speech? He said that it was time, no change. They, just only there will be change in the pronouns. They bought a new dictionary. Okay, in this way. In the same way, wish. Generally, what type of words do we use in unreal past? Yeah, wish, would rather, or would sooner, it's time, had better. Conditional sentences of type 2 and type 3. If I were a bird, I would fly. It is an imaginary situation. We never become a bird, we never fly like that. That means unreal. So that's why we call it as unreal past. Okay, Chinna, is it clear to you? Suppose if you want to get clarity about these unreal parts, we shall take one more class on these unreal parts, children. Yeah, these are the basic changes that take place while changing direct speech into indirect speech. Try to write as many examples as possible on your own and change them into reported speech, children. It will be very clear to you. And I expect from you a lot more answers. And you have to, you write in your notebooks all those, children. Is it clear? If you have any doubt, go through the earlier videos once again and watch it once again. If you have any doubt at any particular example, it will be very clear to you. See how easily we can change these statements or questions from direct speech into indirect speech. In the next session, we can go for imperatives, children. Imperatives, requests, offers, suggestions, how to change. Suppose if anyone offers you something, how to change it into a reported speech, that particular offer. Or if anyone requests you something, how to change that request into a reported speech. Suppose if anyone gives you suggestion, how to change that suggestion into reported speech. All this imperative, and there are so many orders or commands given by your teachers and your parents or elders. How to change all those into reported speech. We can go in detail about all these things in our next session, children. Keep on watching. Okay, thank you.